Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Today's subject is how to save money during the drying with our Atmoset process control. We all know that cylinder dryers are most of the time very old execution. So what we see over here is rather an exception. And what we see in the production are very old executions, which are very inefficient, and they have a lot of fluctuations in terms of the drying, in terms of the residual moisture, and therefore also in terms of the absorbency. What we need is to have a very stable output on the one hand, and of course we need to save money, because how are those units calculated? We have a range, a continuous range in the wet finishing, which is defined mainly with constant speed, because all the other compartments have a certain content which only allow a speed in a certain limitation. And therefore, those cylinder dryers are calculated by the maximum weight and the maximum speed, and of course the water which is inside the fabric. So if you come to a lighter fabric, most of the time, if you don't have any control on these units, you have an overdried fabric. And this leads not only to an unnecessary consumption of a lot of steam, it also leads to a huge fluctuation in the absorbency and the residual moisture. And this is mainly what needs to be avoided, because if you have an overdried fabric, and what is happening is that the fabric, mainly at the cotton side, is taking back the moisture from the environment. It's a hygroscopic fiber, and that means that it really drags the water out of the air and refills it, but this is only happening on the outer sides of the A-frame. The inside of the A-frame will stay bone dry when it is standing there, and that will lead to a balance, a delta between the outer layers of an A-frame and the core of an A-frame. And you can imagine what is happening if you put that lot to the cold pad batch dyeing. You will have most probably between the beginning and the end of such a lot a balance of 8%, and this, ladies and gentlemen, is definitely visible to the human eye. That will be a reprocess work or even a claim, and nobody can afford that these days. So in order to really have a constant and right output in terms of the residual moisture, what would we have to do? First of all, we have to take down that machine into different sections, because three stacks of cylinder dryer are very, very, yeah, let's say, hard to handle. So what we do is that we actually divide that big machine into three different stacks. We can also put two or four cylinder dryers together in one section, in order to not control the speed, but to control the steam which is actually put into that system. This is the one part. And then of course we need to have some tools how we control the speed, the steam, and this is done first of all by the steam traps. So we take the condensate temperature, because the condensate temperature is giving us a clear indication about the temperature of the cylinder dryer itself. So we know the basic load more or less. And then finally, we take what we really need, and this is the residual moisture. The residual moisture should be basic, and this value is then controlling the steam valves at the beginning in the cylinder dryers, in order to increase or decrease that basic load. So as a bottom line, we have those different closed loop systems which are controlled by the residual moisture at the very exit of that process, and with this we can control the residual moisture over the entire time, no matter if there's light fabric or heavy fabric. If there is a heavy fabric, it will of course open up all those steam valves in order to increase the temperature. If there is a light fabric coming, that will be either recognized by the recipe management or, of course, by the residual moisture, and then will automatically put all the valves into position to adapt the temperature of the can dryer accordingly. And this is just one part. The other part is, of course, that all those values will be put into the network. You have the values, you have the data, you can make use of the data. So by putting a new Atmoset into your old cylinder dryer, you can also automatically integrate that cylinder dryer into your professional data network, and you can start using Internet of Things or the Industry 4.0. So again, the big benefit, of course, is that you reduce the energy, that you reduce the steam. You only use the steam amount that you require for that particular fabric. And as a consequence, you will have a stable and constant output of your residual moisture and your absorbency. So the main savings will happen by reducing your failures, by increasing your right first time at the next step during the cold pit batch system or during any other padding system afterwards. We also have some examples about the values, about the savings that you can achieve. Here we have a comparison between the amount of steam which was used before we implemented that Atmoset at a certain customer and afterwards. And here at the mercerizing, we could save 22% of steam. At the other mercerizer, 25%. Another one was done at the processing with 20%, but it can also go up to 36% of steam savings. And once again, I mean, 36% is already a very high figure, but the main saving will be done by reducing your claims, by reducing your reprocess, and by increasing your right first time. Thank you very much for listening to us, and we hope that we can also contribute some savings in your company. Thanks a lot.